Hello everybody, welcome back to the e-learning space of MGM Higher Secondary School, Bokaro. And I am Mrs. Sadaf Noori with a new grammar lesson, lesson number 4. This is the first video for lesson number 4, English class 8. The lesson is pronouns. As we already know, pronouns is one of the 8 parts of speech. These parts of speech together form the skeletal of the grammatical structure. What are pronouns? Pronouns are those words which are used in place of a noun. For example, Sheila is a girl. Sheila goes to school. Over here, the noun Sheila is repeated twice. Instead of repeating it twice in the same sentence or the same context, we can replace the word Sheila with its concerned pronoun. For example, Sheila is a girl. She goes to school. So instead of in a paragraph repeating the same noun over and over again, it is advisable to use the pronoun of the concerned noun. Some of the different kinds of pronoun that we are going to study in this video and which is prescribed in your Grammarite lesson. Here are the types of pronouns. Personal pronoun, emphatic pronoun, reflexive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, distributive pronoun, relative pronoun, possessive pronoun, interrogative pronoun, and indefinite pronoun. Let us deal with each type of pronouns in detail. Personal pronouns. Isn't the name itself very clear? Personal. Something that belongs to a particular person. In the grammatical sense, a personal pronoun is a pronoun that is related mainly to a particular person. Personal pronouns are not limited to people and can also refer to animals and objects. This is the most common type of pronouns that we have learned in our lower classes as well. For example, I, you, we, he, she, it, they. Me, you, us, him, her, it, them. Now I have divided the personal pronouns here into two categories, subject pronouns, object pronouns. As you know, subject is the doer of an action and object is the receiver of an action. So, when we in a sentence use a subject pronoun, it means the noun here was being used as a subject. For example, I am going to school. You are standing near the street light. I is the subject. You is the subject. But if I want to use it as an object, she gave the new pen to me. She is a pronoun here. It is a personal pronoun. But when I say she gave the new pen to me, me is the object here and it is again a pronoun. So a personal pronoun is of two types, subject pronouns and object pronouns. In subject pronoun, let me repeat, the pronoun acts as the subject of an action sentence. And in object pronoun, the pronoun acts as the object in the sentence. Coming to reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns include myself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, yourselves, themselves. Now, reflex, as you know, it is something that stretches, bends, and come back to its own shape if you go for the literal meaning. So reflexive pronoun simply means that pronoun which refers back to the subject of the clause in which they are used. For example, I is a personal pronoun and the reflexive pronoun of I becomes myself. In the same way, we becomes ourselves. Remember to include the plural form. You in singular is yourself and you in plural is yourselves. They becomes themselves and he becomes himself. She becomes herself and it becomes itself. These are the different reflexive pronouns. Look at the examples given here for more clarity. I have told myself that 100 times. So over here, I is the subject and myself is the reflexive pronoun. And when I talk about myself in the sentence, I am referring back to the same subject. I have told myself. This myself is I, the subject. Similarly, look into the second example. We can amuse ourselves for an hour or two. So this personal pronoun we is being referred to by the reflexive pronoun ourselves. So this ourselves is actually the subject we. So in a reflexive pronoun, it refers back to the original subject of the sentence. You are too young to go out by yourself. So over here, yourself refers to you. So this again is a reflexive pronoun. Did you see it yourself? So again, you here is referred to by yourselves. So the use of reflexive pronoun is basically made to refer back to the subject of the clause used in the sentence. Demonstrative pronouns. What are demonstrative pronouns? They are used to show or identify one or a number of nouns that may be far or near in distance or time. Basically, they are used to point out a noun. For example, this, that, these and those. This and that are singular demonstrative pronoun. These and those are plural demonstrative pronoun. They also can be used to show some unspecified quantity in a sentence. Means something that is not particular or specific. That is a beautiful house. I am pointing out to a noun. I am identifying a noun. That is a beautiful house. It is a demonstrative pronoun and it is referring to a specific noun. That is the house. And it is also singular in number because it is referring to only one house. Similarly, I can say those mangoes look ripe. That means those mangoes, which is noun, is at a distance and I'm pointing out and they are not one in number, they are plural. Those mangoes look ripe. These books are old. I'm pointing out to the noun books and they are in plural. Coming to our next slide, relative pronouns. Now look at the title. Relative means something that's showing relation. Relative pronouns take the place of nouns or pronouns. They are called relative pronouns because they always relate back to something or someone else. So it is always showing a relation. They are used to join two sentences about the same person or thing. Let us first see the pronouns, their usage and examples for some more clarity. Pronoun who. This is a relative pronoun and when are they used? It is used to replace the subject pronouns like I, she, he, we and they. Look at the example. This is the man who broke the window. So we are referring to the man and we are showing the relation of the man to the action. This is the man who broke the window. Similarly, come to the second example. Whose. They show possession or relationship. She knew the family whose house we bought. So the family here is being referred to as whose. Whom replaces the objects pronouns like me, her, him, us and them. They have found the lady whom they want to interview. So the lady here is being referred to with the help of the relative pronoun whom. Similarly, coming to the next example, which. Clauses that begin with which are almost always non-restrictive. My precious blue lamp, which was in the room, was broken. So the precious blue lamp is being referred to or related to the action with the help of the relative pronoun which. There's another relative pronoun which is very commonly used, that. Clauses that begin with that are almost always restrictive clauses. The lamp that was in the room was broken. Now, relative pronoun used as a possessive. Here is a small tip for you. The word whose is the only possessive relative pronoun in English. It can be used with both people and things. Look at the example given here in this slide. The family whose house burnt in the fire was immediately given a suite in a hotel. The book whose author is now being shown in the news has become a bestseller. So the word whose in the first sentence refers to the people, family. And in the second sentence it refers to a thing, book. Remember children, it is the only relative pronoun which is used as a possessive pronoun. The next slide is about distributive pronouns. Distributive means something that is distributed in each category, not together, but in a particular manner, separately. Always try to decipher from the title and remember the definition so that you can identify these different kinds of pronouns when they are given in a sentence. Distributive pronouns are pronouns that describe members of a group, a person, things separately and not collectively. It does not point out something in a collective manner. It is a pronoun which is always singular and it should be followed by a singular noun and verb. Look at the examples. Each, every, either, neither, everyone, none, no one, any, etc. What are these words? These are singular words. They must have singular pronouns and verbs. Each of the girls got a medal, referring to every single girl that was present there. Either of you has to come for the wedding, means one among the two. Everyone loves flowers. Okay? None of the four answers is correct. So when there are more than two options, then we use none. Neither of the newspapers is English when there is an option to select between two. So these words are always referring to a person or a group or a thing in a separate manner. Emphatic pronouns are pronoun forms which emphasize on the importance of the noun or pronoun. Remember, it might look like reflexive pronouns, but there is a difference between them. What is the difference? In reflexive pronoun, the word myself, yourself, these are referring back to the subject. However, in emphatic pronouns, when we use these words, myself, yourself, we are actually showing the importance of the noun or the pronoun. For example, I myself saw the masked thief. There's emphasis on the fact that it was me who saw the thief. You yourself should learn to do it. We are again emphasizing on something. So the basic use of emphatic pronouns is to lay stress or emphasis. Hence the word emphatic. Interrogative pronouns. Okay, so from the very elementary level, we are learning that interrogative means questions. So those pronouns which ask questions are called interrogative pronouns. For example, who, whom, which, what. These are used to ask questions about a person or object that we do not know about. And sometimes these words are made into compounds by using EVR, ever, whatever, whoever, whichever. These become again interrogative pronouns, but they lay more strength or emphasis to the word. Here are some words, interrogative pronouns, which it is used when you have a limited choice. What is asked for general information, and who is used when you are asking about a person or name. Now coming to possessive pronouns. Possessive, from the word itself, the meaning of possessive is possession, ownership. When someone or somebody owns something, is the owner of something, it is called, this is in his possession. He possesses it. So when do we use possessive pronoun? In order to show possession or ownership. For example, instead of saying this pen is my pen, not your pen, we can easily say this pen is mine, not yours. This is my laptop, it's mine. So similarly, all the different personal pronouns always have a possessive pronoun. For example, hers, theirs, his, yours, mine, ours. These are the different possessive pronouns that show possession or ownership. Another pronoun prescribed in your syllabus and present in your textbook, Grammarite, is indefinite pronoun. So look at the word indefinite, not definite, or not specific, not particular. So indefinite pronouns are those pronouns which show unspecified objects or people, whether in plural or in singular. These indicate the entire noun or some of the nouns or none of the noun. Means it can be used collectively for a group or separately for each person or maybe for none of them. Used when we want to refer to group of nouns without actually specifying how or who. Okay, look at the examples. Somebody. We are not sure who. We are not sure who is the specified person or object. We are saying somebody. Somewhere. What place? Must be somewhere. Not specified. Anything. Any of the objects from the given list. No one. None of the objects or none of the person. Everybody. No one in particular, but the entire group. So it fits the definition. Uses those pronouns which are used to point out either a single person or noun, or a group of person or noun, or maybe none of the persons of noun, but they're always unspecified. They are not particular, they are not specific, they are not definite. Hence the word indefinite. Now this brings us to the end of different kinds of pronouns that we have in your textbook, the Grammarite, for class 8. However, this is not the end of the lesson. In our next video, we are going to discuss the same pronouns in a little bit more detail along with the textual exercises and the additional exercises that are given to you. So kindly go through the video once again, and if you have any confusion, we are going to discuss it in our online classes. For now, children, thank you and take care.